Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Boeing amid reports the U.S. Justice Department has opened a criminal investigation into the Alaska Airlines mid-air fuselage breach in January. The embattled plane maker shares dropped over 1% in pre-market trading. Also in focus, shares of Honda after the U.S. National Highway Traffic Safety Administration launched a probe into over 250,000 vehicles over brake issues. New York-listed shares of Honda are down 2% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of British electrical retailer Currys. U.S. investment firm Elliott said it will not make another takeover bid for the company after repeatedly being rejected. Currys shares fell 8% on the news.
Asian markets kicked off the week mostly lower. The Nikkei 225 led losses in the region. That's after an upward revision to Japan's Q4 GDP, which showed it avoided a technical recession, boosted expectations the Bank of Japan will be able to raise interest rates soon. The local bourse joined the downswing, with the main index stumbling 1%.
Market is kind of hesitating here at the 7,000 level and is now, you know, moving sideways in the short term. This market is still going to trend up in the medium term, especially given if there will be rate cuts moving forward. If you look at it in terms of the price earnings ratio, no, 10 times is considered cheap, no, and 20 times or more is considered expensive. This market is currently trading at 13. So although we've had quite a run in the last couple of months, we are still considered cheap by that metric.
In notable stock movements in the region, shares of state-backed China Vanke jumped more than 3% on Monday, or in Monday trade on news. The Chinese government has asked banks to support the embattled property firm.
American companies set to invest over $1 billion in the Philippines. U.S. Commerce Secretary Gina Raimondo shared the news during the first day of her trade and investment mission to Manila. She says some firms eyeing to invest include Google, Microsoft, Visa, MasterCard, and United Airlines.
U.S. companies are interested to invest in Filipinos. Just look at the many American companies that provide employment and professional development for thousands of Filipinos, putting them on a path to higher paying jobs.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. also urged the American firms to take part in his administration's infrastructure program. Washington's delegation visited the chief executive in the Malacañang Monday. Marcos touted the Build Better More program as an initiative worth around $148 billion, aiming to actualize nearly 200 high-impact infrastructure projects.
Investing in our country presents a multitude of advantages for investors looking to grow, to expand. In the heart of Southeast Asia, the Philippines offers a strategic location for businesses to succeed.
Now, despite an aggressive push to attract overseas investors, foreign direct investments in the Philippines declined in 2023. Data from the central bank showed FDI net inflows fell 6.6% last year to $8.9 billion. The BSP attributed that to concerns over subdued global economic growth and geopolitical risks weighing on investors' minds. Majority of the investments went to debt instruments, with Japan as the top country source, mostly directed to the manufacturing industry.